I'm Maureen in Santa Clara, California, on Immaculate Heart Radio. You're on the air with Leah Darrow.
Yes, Darrow. I am calling to ask you, I have a young daughter. She's a junior in high school, and she has been modeling. They caught her when she was in eighth grade. She has not gone to church anymore. She does hand modeling, and she does some runway modeling, but what caught her eye was I entered her in a San Francisco beauty pageant at age 13 because she felt so insecure and nobody liked her. She thought she was ugly. So anyway, she had a, you know, complex problem.
Okay, Maureen, so I didn't think just let me step in a little bit. Your sound is kind of wobbling up and down. Can you talk right into your phone for me?
There you go.
That much better. Yeah, you said something at the top I missed. Did you say they caught her at 13?
Right, at a San Francisco beauty pageant.
By you mean an agent or someone who made an offer
or
a connection?
Yes.
Oh, okay,
yes.
Okay.
Because she actually won, and I'm just like, I remember my ex hit me in the arm saying, guess who's going to Florida to the Nationals? And I'm like, there's no way. Because I entered her just to, you know, get her self-esteem because she said that's what she wanted to do. So anyway, so now she's a junior in high school. She has nothing to do with mom anymore.
So,
but
Maureen, it's Patrick here. There's so many layers to this story. You said your ex.
So anyway,
okay, hold on a sec, Maureen. I just want to get to what you're really asking. You said your ex. Is your ex, Maureen, your daughter's father?
Correct.
And are you Catholics?
Yes. Well, I am.
Okay.
They are. They're all Catholics, but they're no longer practicing.
Okay. And your daughter's kind of drifting, and you want to know how to balance encouraging chastity and dignity without being a helicopter mom who's annoying and overbearing. Is that the heart of your question?
Yeah. Well, right. But basically,
okay.
I have nothing to do with them. But I would love to give her your book and your website to encourage her. But I just need some kind of information, you know, as to how she went about it, because this all has to do with her modeling. And I have two daughters. They're both, they're 14 months apart. But anyway, she's the one that has always been drifting. And
Maureen, that you've called the right guest and the right show. And I do hope your daughter's listening right now, or you share with her the podcast of the answer you're about to receive, because this is a great question and really uniquely fitted to Leah's background. Leah, what would you say?
Okay, so you're asking like what you can do now to reach out to her to bring her back to the church. Is that what we're going for?
Correct. Because she refused to make her confirmation, and, you know, at 13 she was modeling, and I'm just like, she's still modeling, but she just refuses to have anything to do with the Catholic upbringing. Her grandmother, my mom, is just horrified at it.
Right. Well, unfortunately, there's nothing in the beauty industry that's going to help her with her insecurity. In fact, it's only going to make it worse. But what you can pray for is pray for that hopefully somehow that comes to an end, and pray that she can come to a place where she comes back to you. I know when I had my conversion, one of the big elements for me was the fact that I still kept in contact with my parents. And even though she might not be in contact with you and you might not be close right now, always keep yourself open and available to her, and reach out to her regardless, because you are the parent, she is not. And reach out to her, love her, you know, try to still connect with her and communicate and dialogue with her, even if she says no every single time, because that will help her realize that you will always be there for her, and you're never going to be like, I told you so. When I made that phone call back home, I made it, and I was desperate, and I was at the lowest of the low, but I knew I could call and I could get help from my parents. Even though my parents were very clear and they told me they didn't like my lifestyle, they were open enough to me to listen to my call for help, and they came and they helped me and they were there for me. And one of the best things that they could have done was just being a parent saying no to me to all the things they should have said no to, loving me regardless of my crazy life, and always being there for me. I can't tell you how much that meant to me and how much it mattered and how big of a role that played in my conversion. As simple as just being there and being available and loving your daughter and then never, ever giving up on prayer for her.
Maureen, I hope that was a help. I was thinking of St. Monica, whose feast day is arriving soon. Her son, Augustine, is called the Son of Tears because of the probably 15 or 20 years of daily deluge of tears as St. Augustine's mother begged heaven for her son to come back, which he did. And this is why he's called St. Augustine. So we'll pray for your daughter as well. Maureen, thanks for the call in Santa Clara.